Hey everybody, Ethan here with Mark Rodney Productions. I'm here at the Building Legacy Studio with Cameron Worsham, a buddy of ours that we go way back, high school, did a lot of projects together. So excited to be here and just highlight what you're doing today in your studio. Show off a little bit of, they've got a podcast here. So the nuts and bolts on how all of that works. We'll dive into all of that. I had the opportunity to work with them to kind of help get set up, and this is an offering that we do for other clients. So if you need a setup like this or you're curious on how to do it, we want to throw these videos out on YouTube, so hopefully you can learn something from that. But then if you need more specific help, feel free to reach out to us. But Cam, why don't you tell us a little bit about Building Legacy and your role here and some of the stuff you do?
Sure. So I'm the creative director for Building Legacy, and basically it's a podcast brand that pulls athletes, entrepreneurs, we're about to have some spiritual guests on here, like pastors and such, all to better individuals in their lives and their families and financial lives and stuff. So
why don't you just kind of walk us through what you got going on? We'll start over here maybe with the microphones.
I guess starting off, the most important thing is probably the Blackmagic 4Ks. We have three of them. So these are on 25s, which translate to like a 50.
And you used Micro Four Thirds lenses to keep it budget friendly, I imagine, for through the three cameras.
Yep. I mean, these are super cheap, and they have a pretty shallow depth of field. I think it's 1.7.
Oh, great.
So yeah, I mean, I think I sit on a 2.8 to match this lens.
Okay.
Because that one I'm looking at wide and it only goes down to, I think, 2.8. So Blackmagic's, and then this is the what? Rodecast or something?
The Rode Pod Mic?
I think it is. They're pretty good. I've had really good, I don't need anything better.
Yeah.
Especially for right now.
They're much better. Really, like, why pay $400 for a Shure SM7B when you can have a great sounding mic here?
The other thing is, like, nobody notices it unless you're in the actual industry. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Like, nobody cares. This sounds great. And especially with the Rode, what's that called? The sound?
The Rodecaster Pro.
The Rodecaster Pro. You can change things on there to make this sound even better or just how you want it to sound. So
yeah.
I'm completely happy with it. This arm is great.
One thing with these mics, I'm kind of curious with your experience. Yeah. There's a lot of handling noise and sometimes plosives can be hard. So being on the arm, has that fixed a lot of that problem, or is it just kind of like you're kind of gentle with the table, or do you have any problem with handling noise at all?
I tell you what, I don't really have much, because even like when I've been on the podcast, for some reason, when I watch it back, I'm usually doing this a lot. I don't really, unless I really get it, like I really smack the mic, I don't notice much.
Good.
For plosives, honestly, I don't notice much of them either. And that's probably partially because I have an untrained ear. But yeah, I mean, there's nothing that really kills me.
Cool.
Like there's no really aggressive sounds.
Yeah. So. Cool, love that. I think generally if you speak across like the microphone rather than talking directly into it, sometimes that can help
and
a lot.
And this is the angle that we kind of, I'll show you real quick. So usually Devin sits here and this is usually the kind of thing we got going on. So it's not like I'm, you know, drinking it like a pop or whatever. It's like skimming off the top, but it still is collecting, you know, a good amount. So
awesome. Notice you got some lights, some C-stands. Talk us through some of that.
These are the Amaran 60Ds, or are they changed? What are they now? Updated them, 60Ds.
Yep.
Just a little soft box. I'm doing a little egg crate on these. I think I'm blasting like 100% right now.
Yep.
C-stand, I don't know.
Do you run continuous power to the cameras?
I do. That's what all these cords are for. That's why it looks so bad. Continuous power, HDMI to all three of these. And the HDMI circles back to
the command center back here.
Yeah, the command center is where I sit. A10 Mini Pro, camera hookups and everything. This is my little warning label.
And then are you recording to an SSD then?
Yes, yep. So I'll throw one of these SSDs, and then you can see that.
T7. T7.
Or nice. T5, it don't matter.
Yep.
Throw it in here, record. This is the audio, comes into here. This thing's really nice. It's so nice, I don't know how to take control of all the nice things.
Yeah, like
it's so, yeah, yeah. It's so much, I can't, it's not much I can do. Yeah, and so I'll basically sit here, I'll watch the production on this monitor and kind of cut with my eyes and just sit here and be part of the conversation.
Would we be able to like turn it on at some point and do a little test to see
sure.
how it looks?
Yeah.
Cool, that might be fun.
Yeah. Let's see. I mean, that's pretty much the setup.
Cool.
There's not much more. I'll have a computer back there projecting that onto the, or if like we want to get on the internet or something or watch something.
Yeah.
I'll throw it up there.
And then I noticed you have a microphone back here. Do you use this or is this running
yeah.
into the same setup?
Yep.
Cool.
So I'll just, what do I do? Something like this. Boom.
And that's when you're running the show
good.
From back here
yep.
for, Devin is the main guy, right? And
yep.
then whatever guest is on the show.
Sometimes it's nice to have the conversation, but then to break the fourth wall of a podcast
yeah.
or something, I don't really know the exact definition of that. But it's kind of nice just to see that, oh, this is an actual production. Someone's actually running it. It's controlled, you know, it's professional.
And now we can just speak straight into it.
Yeah.
I have it taped here, like where I like everything.
Your levels.
If I want to talk back here, yeah.
That's awesome.
So,
great.
I'll turn on the cameras.
So we just wanted to actually check out the setup here. So we're on the mics now. We got the three cameras rolling. We got Brody back there switching. So if it looks terrible, blame him.
Pretty much.
Yeah. So how long do you guys normally shoot your episodes? Like how long are your episodes?
So yeah, we go for about, I'd say average an hour and a half.
Probably. An hour and a half. Wow. Okay.
Yeah, I know. It's a long time
yeah.
comparatively, but dude, you're sitting here having a good conversation with someone.
Yeah, take
at
your
some
time.
At some point, I'm like, screw the production. It is what it is. If someone is enjoying the conversation, they might stay for all of it.
Yeah.
Or they'll just throw it on their car and be like, I'm just going to sit here and soak it all in.
Yeah, and a lot of people speed up the episodes. Like they're listening to like 1.5 times speed or something, which
That's
is interesting.
True.
Well, thanks for checking out this video. And thanks for giving us the studio tour. We got a really cool setup here. It was really fun to work with you guys on this one. You guys got a lot of great content already, and I'm excited to see what you create in the future. So I'll link some of those links in the description of this video to the podcast, to the website, things like that. And maybe to your episode, because you were a guest on the show as well.
I was,
right?
Yeah.
Cool.
Yeah, and I appreciate it. I mean, couldn't have done any of this without you and your knowledge in this area, hooking everything up. I mean, I just know how to work a camera pretty much. You
yeah.
know what I mean? So when I came into it, you set everything up for me, and it's been smooth sailing. Like, I have not had one hitch, really. We've
Good.
Just had a great production. So
Good. I appreciate that.
Appreciate yeah. it.
Feels so official.
To be like, just still like high school buddies hanging out.
All right.
And you can, I love it too, because you can see
the tally lights.
Yeah.
Yeah. That's sick. These arms are nice. I got like the cheapest, like Amazon.
They're pretty good. Worth the money, I think.
Yeah. We got Brody back there switching. So if it looks terrible, blame him.
Pretty much.
So this is pretty much how it goes, right?
He wants to say something so bad.
Yeah. Whatever he's not in front of camera, it's killing him.
That's correct.
Correct, he says. And I'll link some of the website and the podcast in the show notes down. It's not show notes because it's podcast. I'm saying show notes in the description. Okay, one more time, Broads. That podcast as well.
What happened? Do you still hear yourself?
Yeah.
Oh. Did you hit something?